full of donuts, potato lockers and l'chaims for the grown-ups. The Hanukkah.
Hello and welcome to a special episode of Sleigh, Whaaat. I have
my friend Melanie Ross, and we just finished watching Hallmark's Eight Nights of Hanukkah.
Eight Gifts of Hanukkah.
Eight Gifts of Hanukkah. See, I got the title wrong. Melanie, would you like to unpack your experience with this? You are our guest Sleigh Whaaat host tonight.
So, I was very excited that finally us Jews have a Hanukkah holiday movie. First of its kind, really. And I'm really thankful that for most of the leads, they were Jewish, so they cast authentically, which was really great. There were some nice moments in this movie. They definitely added so much culture in there. They had, there were certain moments where I was like, okay, they're trying way too hard, like certain phrases where it's like, you don't need to say it in like every second. Like, we get it. This is a Hanukkah movie. You don't have to like remind us like every single scene that there's a Hanukkah. Like, we get it. So
yes, I feel like they did that for people like me and not people like you. Where I was like,
true,
oh,
true.
Something new. And you were like, wait, why did they bring this in? And I was going to say, well, yeah, I don't mind it.
That's interesting. Yeah. Cause for me, I'm like, okay, we don't really do this or that, but like, I guess for people who don't celebrate or not part of the culture, they're like, oh, okay, I get it. I get it. So yeah, interesting in that sense. Like, there's one moment where this guy Daniel gives her a dreidel. Like, we don't do that. Like, you don't need to give someone a dreidel. Like, maybe.
And meanwhile, I thought that moment was sweet. But wait, we have to backtrack and give them a little, like, the premise of what it is. So it follows this like optometrist lady called Sarah Levin, who basically mm-hmm. is following in the footsteps of her mother, her grandmother, who was a survivor. And basically, each night of Hanukkah, she gets a surprise gift from a secret admirer. And she's like newly single after a long-term relationship. So there are like four potential guys that it could be. And the whole time she's like, I wonder who it is. We were getting really annoyed as we were watching it because it was kind of painfully obvious.
Yeah, it was painfully obvious because every time they were together, there was so much tension there. And we could see that she felt the tension, and then she would give him the cold shoulder. But then she'd be like, oh, who is it? Who could it be? Who are giving me these gifts? But like, girl, you feel the tension. We know this.
Literally.
So clearly, it was not a female who wrote this movie.
There was a token black best friend, which we love. And
two tokens.
Like, yes, there were two token black best friends, which I feel like is usually a staple with the Christmas movies and holiday movies in general. What was interesting is like in the first scene, the main leads, so the Sarah girl is dressed in all blue. She has like a bluish purpley coat, and then her best friend has a red coat because like the place is decorated in both blue and red because they're compromising because the best friend celebrates Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
It was hilarious.
And so every time you see her, she's in wearing red while all the Jewish leads are wearing blue, everything blue. The curtains blue, placemats blue, everything blue.
The vase is blue.
Just a reminder, in case you didn't know, they're Jewish, that they're wearing blue.
Yeah, you came up with a really fun slogan. Do you want to tell them the slogan you came up with?
If they're wearing blue, it's Jew.
There you go. Scenes which were weird because like they would start scenes and then suddenly the next scene was like the end of the last scene where it was like, hey, come over to our house. Let's discuss the fundraiser. And then the next scene was like, well, thanks for discussing the fundraiser.
Right. And so it's like, come on, why don't we have that moment? We wanted to see those scenes. But of course, this is a movie where you have to see all eight nights. So I guess they did have to cut some things, but it still would have been nice to get to see those scenes rather than hear about it. But
they're hosting a fundraiser for the Jewish Community Center called the Mazel Ball.
Mm-hmm.
I just like love the title.
Cute name.
What was the other thing? I made notes.
We have one of the guys she dated, Nigel, who was the chef, who was British.
And, yes.
Mm-hmm, nice accent. Nice little change up. He always wore black because he was the outsider. So he couldn't be wearing red, he couldn't be wearing blue.
Yeah, he couldn't do either of that. It would just be too confusing for our very simple brain. So the grandmother was very integral to this movie, and that's kind of what brings it in together and makes it even more emotional. And the ending, we're not gonna tell you what the ending was unbelievable. That like Melanie was screaming and then the movie ended and then it went to credits.
I was like, this needs to cut right now.
And then we saw the sneak peek of another movie and she was like, wait, that's how the movie ends? Yes. And she's like, I need a sequel.
I need a sequel because there's so many things unanswered we need to know. There's so many things that just freaking ended right then and there. Like, no, that's not a good closure for me.
I kind of wish that they had, I kind of wish they developed the brother a bit more, the mom and the dad, and the little girl. Because in the beginning, there's like this nice little, it's like the first night and they're about to like light the menorah. And everyone's together, so you're assuming, okay, there's going to be, like, a lot of family in this film. But then later on, the film is just, like, her and all these guys and being like, who is it? Who's getting me all these
could it
presents?
Be? Oh, and my goodness. Like, and this is what I was telling Von Guy. I was saying, if this was written by a woman, you will know the first day that she received her nominus gift, she would know who it is, and she would play along. Or she would call the dude out. Because, listen, we all knew it. She was not that oblivious. Women are smart. Come on.
But it was cute. Like, you know, the two main people had their little song. Which it was like a nice Smallville moment. So
Hanukkah.
So, you can choose how you'd like to rate. Would you like to rate out of stars or menorahs? And I always rate out of 5 candy canes. No one has ever gotten 5 from me.
Let's do out of 8 nights. 5 out of 8 nights.
5 out of 8 nights. That's pretty dope.
I think because I'm very pleased. For overall, I'm pleased that for what it was, because I know going into this is one of those cheesy holiday movies. So there's going to be things. I'm glad I got to see, you know, the culture in there and all that. But with that said, as we were saying, the writing, I'm not so much a fan of. And I'm peeved about the end. So I want a part 2. And yeah.
Sweet stuff. So it's been Melanie Roth, my guest commentator on this special Hanukkah episode of Sleigh, What? It's been lovely having you. Thank you, lady.
Thank you.
And we will catch y'all on the next episode.